Hello there, my beautiful lovey doveys. So, my name is Trudy and I'm your Portuguese gypsy. So, today I decided to do a no communication reading because a lot of the collective that is viewing on YouTube is in a no communication situation of some sort. The vast majority, not everybody, okay? And like this is happening because collective consciousness is rising to a new level, especially with all of these eclipses and, you know, Mercury retrogrades that we've been going through and other planetary retrogrades like Venus and Jupiter, and all of the planets have been doing their beautiful divine cosmic dance. And we, alongside them, have been going through our own evolution. And so I commend everybody who has actually taken it upon themselves to self-examine and grow to a higher height, right? Okay. Sorry, I almost knocked a bunch of stuff over. So I'm using the Gilded Tarot, and I'm going to start off with the bottom of the deck energy because this goes for the whole collective. It doesn't matter which card you chose. This is a collective energy, and it's the Ace of Cups. So it's a brand new beginning, y'all. Brand new beginning! And this is super exciting because it's not just any ace, it's the Ace of Cups, so that means that it's coming from a heart chakra space. The Anahata chakra. It's so beautiful. For some people, this means that they're for the first time ever going to express their feelings truthfully, genuinely, and authentically. For some people, this means that they are going to stop people pleasing and finally begin to honor themselves. So this is all coming from a beautiful heart space, a genuine and authentic heart space, and it takes a lot of balls and a lot of courage to do that sometimes. So I wanted to put that out there. This is for all of the collective, yourself and the person that you're watching the reading about. Now, some of you, I'm not gonna say names, okay? Some of y'all like to have a couple balls to juggle around, and you don't keep it limited to just one person. No judgment. Hey, some people like to play the field. So if you want to appoint the cards to more than one person, I've got a deck for Carnelian. So if you pick Carnelian, I have three stacks of cards. I have a stack for Carnelian, okay? I have a stack for Amethyst, and I have a stack for Clear Crystal Quartz, all right? So you have to make a selection. Like if you're gonna use more than one person, you wanna appoint like, okay, Carnelian is gonna be Michelle or David. I'm just saying whatever names, okay? And Amethyst is going to be Adam or Shirley. I'm making names up, okay? And Clear Crystal Quartz is going to be Lewis and Fernanda. All right? I'm just totally making names up. So whatever you feel like, if your situation is with three dudes, you know, appoint the cards accordingly. If your situation is with one person, you can do how I'm doing in my head, right? Actually, because I don't get tarot card readings and I don't read cards for myself. So this is my way of checking in on the energy because it's collective. So I'm included, but it's not directly for me, right? So this is what I'm going to do in my case. One of the stones is for me, and the other stone that I'm going to pick is for my counterpart, my person that I'm thinking about. Not necessarily my person, okay? But my person that I'm thinking about for this particular reading, okay? So now, moving forward, I'm going to start with the Carnelian group. If you haven't made your selection, pause the video. We got Carnelian, Amethyst, Clear Crystal Quartz. Pause the video now because I'm going to start with the Carnelian people. We are ready. Carnelian vibes. Okay, so, you know, the person that you're thinking of that's not talking to you, the reason that they're not talking to you, for starters, they feel like you hate them. Secondly, they feel like they have nothing to give you and they're in a bad financial situation. And they feel like those finances aren't nearly good enough for you. So they're stuck between a rock and a hard spot, and that's why they're not reaching out to you. So like they're all up inside of their head. They feel like also you hate them because of perhaps the last encounter. They feel like you are this beautiful butterfly who has wandered away from the situation because the situation that they have surrounded themselves in is so hostile that a butterfly would never dream of hanging out in this World War III atmosphere. No thanks. I'm gonna fly south for the winter and peace. I'll be in Mexico. Mazatlan. No, I'm just kidding, but like, really, like, why would a butterfly hang out somewhere where it's like really cold or too hot or like full of, you know, concrete jungle? I don't know, like, no love. Why would a butterfly hang out for this? A butterfly is going to go somewhere where it's welcomed and where its chances of survival are going to increase instead of decrease. That just makes so much sense. But this person is keeping everything really close to them. Their money, their intentions with money, their intentions for the future, their feelings, their thoughts, their emotions. They don't share that with anybody. And they shared a lot of it with you. They feel like it. They could share that with you. But at the same time, they feel like it's not good enough for you. So they're stuck. And that's where they're at. All right, so that's your reading. I'm moving on to the Amethyst group. Somebody timestamp it. Amethyst group is at 7 minutes and 38 seconds. So here we start. Amethyst. Let's see. What do we got? So your person is also spending a lot of time alone. I say also. I feel like both of you guys are spending time alone. Or even if you are surrounded by a great deal of people, you're not. You're like, hey. Okay, bye. Just being cordial. And, God, you really miss being with this person, or they really miss being with you. They miss having you in their bed. They miss cuddling with you. They miss all the bound chicka wow. They miss all of it. And they miss the way that you smell. They want to find their way back to you, but it's really burdensome to their heart and soul to come in your direction for some reason. It's like the wrong time. They're not ready to do it. There's something really burdensome holding them back from coming forward to you. They're not ready. Hate it when they're not ready. Like, how long do you want us to wait? No waiting, by the way. I'm not encouraging waiting by any means, way, shape, or form. You should not wait. You should move on with your life. And that's going to encourage the energy from the other person to move faster in your direction, baby. So move on. Move on. All right, my lovey-doveys. Now I'm starting with the clear crystal quartz at 9 minutes and 40 seconds. So you could be dealing with a Virgo right off rip. That's coming out. It's giving Virgo vibes. It's giving Virgo vibes. So, Your person is crying over spilled milk. They have tried really hard. They have searched high and low for your replacement. They have, taken a deep dive into work. They have filled their plate with everything to do to try to forget about you, but they can't. They cannot forget you, baby, because you are unforgettable. That's what you are. Unforgettable, though near or far. That's so beautiful. You need to look up that song, by the way. Unforgettable, Nat King Cole, Natalie Cole. That's a beautiful song. And that's like, I'm getting this from the Virgo vibes reading. That's so funny. I got a lot of Virgo vibes. Also, like, this person has been planning to come your way for a very long time. Like, this could be years in some cases. This person has been planning strategically to come your way and how to come your way for such a long time. He's coming up as the Knight of Pentacles, and the Knight of Pentacles, out of all of the knights, is the most responsible one, the most reliable, dependable, hardworking, steadfast, has a sense of responsibility and a sense of what am I trying to say? Like, they have a sense of honor, an old-fashioned kind of honor. And your opinion seriously matters to them. And they've spent a great deal of time in reflection, and they want to fix whatever it is that they did wrong, because they keep crying over it, and they can't stop looking in the direction of the past. They want to fix it. They want to come back, they want to fix it. And in the meantime, they're standing in the shadows, because they're figuring out how to secure a yes from you as opposed to anything else. All right, so I'm gonna close out the reading here. Leave me comments, leave me an emoji, even if you don't want to leave me comments, okay? And if you want a private exchange of energies with me, click on the description box below. Follow the instructions and we will totally make it happen. So I love you, love me back, love yourself, love everybody around you. Mwah.